Today we have on Dancing with the Stars, All-Stars Tabs. No, no, they're fantastic. Melissa and Tony and the runners-up, Sean, Derek, Kelly, and Val. Now, I know some of y'all watched last night.
Yes.
I did. I don't usually.
Yes, you watched it, Barbara.
I got
what did you think?
But I'll tell you, you know, I was very happy whoever won. I can't tell the professionals from the, you know, I can't tell the pros
because
from
the professionals have become stars themselves.
But this is what I don't get.
Okay.
So, you know, they go through all of this. At the end of the thing comes this sort of, I know, this big ugly ball
disco
that they get, some heavy ball. You have no place to put it when you get home.
But you know, Barbara,
you don't get a free trip to Bermuda. Woo. You don't get a.
No.
But you know what? It's not.
It's not even.
You get money.
The ball.
No,
you
do. No,
you do. Yes, you do. Yes, you do get some money. Yeah. You. No, no, you do get money. You do get. You get a nice little chunk of money. But what that mirror ball symbolizes, that big disco ball, and I can't speak for them, but for me is you go outside of your comfort zone and you do something that scares you, and you get you push past pain, physical exhaustion, mental exhaustion. Injuries, and so it's not about the prize.
The mirror ball.
But then when you finally get past it, you say, because Kelly Monaco said this, you go, I did this and I was scared and I didn't know how to dance. Yeah. It showed me that I can do anything.
I
and it and
that,
I think
but why a ball?
Just getting
why
into
this
my new
junkie
brazier,
ball?
I should get an award like that. Pushing past your comfort zone, you know?
You go past your comfort zone and you gotta dig deep, and a lot of people don't dig deep and find that thing.
That's
they
right.
stop when they get you know, they don't get comfortable.
Did you dig deep and find your
I got voted off in the fourth week. You see, I cried like a baby when I got voted off.
She's not angling to get back on that show.
I want to go back on Dancing with the Stars.
Would you do the next round of All Stars?
In a heartbeat, arthritis in my knees and all. I would get right back on that show.
Why asked Tony Davolani who was the worst? Who were the worst dancers? And your name did not come up.
Oh, that was so sweet.
Well, that was very sweet.
Make that.
I didn't even make the but you know, it is. I couldn't even make that. I just take a smile with it.
All you got was mediocre, right?
I did, but you know, because my partner Val, I wanted him to do lifts, and I tried to do a lift with him, and he just said, oh, he couldn't, you know, but I want to do a lift. Sorry, Wilt.
Down to the very last dance on this season of Dancing with the Stars All Stars. And even though the mirror ball slipped through their fingers, both runners-up have plenty to be proud of. First performing the Paso Doble to the song España Cani. Here are runners-up Kelly Monaco and Val Schmerkowski. Okay, congratulations for making it to the finals, you and Val. This is my little boy right here.
He speaks the world of you.
Oh, because I love him so, and I love you, but you've got to let us know about these rumors, okay? The show is over. You emanate so much heat, sexuality, lust. I got pregnant with you two watching you guys.
Well,
you better tell me what is going on with with you and Val, Kelly?
I mean, you guys are watching it.
Yeah, we watch it.
I would never cheat on you, Shay.
There's something going on. I watch it. He did lifts. He never did a lift with me. Like I said, when I ran towards Val, his knees buckled. No, you can't. Don't even try. That's 160-something pounds. You'll hurt your back. But, you know, you guys are so wonderful. What you said yesterday, anybody can do anything just watching you. What did you get out of this?
I think that the biggest thing, obviously, this amazing friendship that I made with Val. And the confidence that you build in yourself throughout this experience, and I think you know that as well. If you put your mind to anything, you can do it. And he obviously guided me in the right direction, sure, but really, truly built me up.
Do you feel better this go around? Because you actually had the biggest gap, right, from the first time, you're the very first.
7+ years, yeah. This time around, I feel 100% better. I feel like I actually learned how to dance this time.
Yeah.
For the first time, it was a new show. No one really knew what we were doing. And we just kind of got through it.
You got through it.
Yeah.
But you know, you're a major star on General Hospital. And I hear, Val, you're also going to be on General Hospital?
Yes, he is.
What is this?
I don't know. I guess Kelly pulled some strings for me, and I got a little cameo.
No, he's very talented.
Will you be dancing,
or are you? His own strings.
I will not be dancing.
Okay, all right. That sounds good. Well, we love you both. Next up is another couple who can hold their own heads up high this morning, dancing to the nicest kids in town. Please welcome Dancing with the Stars All Stars, Shawn Johnson and Derek Hough. You got close, Melissa, when you and Tony went 14 seasons. Both of you tell me, what does redemption taste like? What does it feel like?
It tastes good. It's really good.
I waited 14 seasons for this experience, and it was worth all of it.
And I got to say about Tony. Disappointments and partners who are a little questionable, no names. But you've always had a smile on your face, and everybody loves you. You could see it. They were so happy when you won. Melissa, what do you say to that about Tony?
Well, I think it should make him feel really good. You know, everybody was behind him this season. I think he challenged himself in ways that he didn't even expect to. You know, and I'm proud of him. I'm so glad we got to do this together.
I'm so enjoying that you're all out of breath like this. I thought it was just me when I walk up a flight of stairs.
You know who's proud of your sweet little girl? She is absolutely adorable. Seven, watching you cheering her daddy on.
What's special about last night was that it was my wife's and my 13th anniversary. It was great. My daughter takes gymnastics and she dances. She loves Shawn, of course. My wife is taking lessons at a Dance With Me Studios, which Max and I own together with Val.
So tell me something, this mirror ball trophy, because you were just like, where are you going to keep this trophy, Melissa and Tony?
I want to put it like on the roof of my house or the hood of my car, somewhere where everybody can see it at all times.
At all times, light it up. You guys, though, you both suffered some serious injuries along the way. Were you concerned at any point that you weren't going to make it through?
Well, we had 2 Mondays where we were not cleared from doctors to dance. Right. So, you know.
Your neck. You had to go to the hospital.
I had to go to the hospital. He actually went to the hospital for his back. But, you know, an injury is not the way you want to leave this competition. Right. And if it's something that is just pain management, you just kind of work through it.
Are you guys in pain right now?
Do you keep dancing now or do you say,
I will burn these right here. That's how done I am with dancing.
Can somebody speak to the fact, because Barbara wanted to know, you know, you get this cheesy mirror ball.
This one's got Swarovski's on it.
Swarovski crystals, but what do you get? What is it? Why do people...
It's not cheesy.
Why do you come back to Dancing with the Stars?
Anything besides the crystal ball?
Ours is just mirrored.
It's just a symbolization.
We gotta go. We love you all. We want to thank everybody at Dancing with the Stars. Have a great day, everybody, and take a little time to enjoy the view.
Wednesday's new hit drama Nashville is a can't miss tonight at 10, 9 Central on ABC.